Sir,
this
is Manunga Studio. You are right at the spot where Manunga Studio is being produced, and it's a pleasure to have you here on board. What can you say to the public, to Manunga Studio's viewers? Who are you, the man, Mr. Daniel Mepin?
Yeah, my name is Daniel Mepin. I'm a Cameroonian. I'm on retirement. I'm the teacher by profession, but I've settled now in Cameroon as a writer. I write in German, I write in French, a bit also in English. And, you know, I happen to have known Manunga, the YouTube, and yeah. I'm really impressed how it functions.
So, you talk of Manunga Studio on YouTube. Yes, it is how can I say it? It's because of some sort of interest by myself. But we are here to talk about you. You, Daniel Mepin, as a writer, you are now in Germany visiting. After you last left 12 years ago, I understand.
Yeah.
What has brought you back to Germany this time? What have you got in your bag?
Thank you very much. I've had good luck enough to have one of my plays, a stage in Mannheim by the Tick Sieben
a theater located at Mannheim.
Yeah,
Mannheim.
They invited me.
Germany.
Yeah,
yes.
As a playwright, and I went there, and I just took the opportunity to have a look, to pay some visits in Germany before going back.
So you bumped on Manunga Studio.
Yeah, Manunga Studio.
Yes, yeah, a big surprise for you, as you said.
Yes.
Yeah, it's true. But as you yourself know, passions exist not from today up to tomorrow, but passions have been nursed sometimes in the early stages of our lives. How come you started writing? When did you first have that idea that you could write? Because do you have a message to portray, or it's just out of lack of something to do now that you are retired? Why are you a writer?
Yeah.
When did you become a writer?
Very interesting question. I dreamt many years ago, when I was still in the secondary school, that I should become a writer, because it's so interesting to be telling people things about Cameroon, things about my own people in the Western province. And I'm a lover of languages, so I said it's good to leave something behind when one can have things to say. I started writing because I considered that I saw that I wrote, for example, the first writing was in English because I wanted to improve my English. By the way, I worked in the Northwest Government High School, Cambay, as vice principal. And when I was posted to Germany to write, to work as a cultural attaché, I wanted to get something back to Cameroon, and I went into writing as German to sell Cameroon, so to speak.
So you were
directly
cultural,
to the Germans.
So you, as you are a cultural attaché, you really use the word in its real sense, cultural attaché, the man attached to culture,
yes.
Binding both cultures together.
Now, right.
Now you said you made mention that you are from the Western Province.
Yes.
But how come you are so fluent in English? Did you go to school in the Francophone system, or how come? When did you get contact with English?
Yeah, I studied English at the grammar school in Yaoundé. But I added sciences and mathematics in the lycée in the Leclerc. But since I wanted to be a writer, I changed when I went into Ecole Supérieure Teachers Training College, and I studied English, and I fell in love with English because I liked it so much. And I studied in the bilingual section in the Ecole Supérieure in the University of Yaoundé, and I taught in English, so, Bafoussam and Yaoundé, and worked as I said, in the Northwest as vice principal, and I improved my English.
So it's very, very encouraging to realize that you had started so early with the bilingualism, taking it into your own private life. Yeah. And now, we first met in 1987 when you picked me up together with 51 other young Cameroonians who were on scholarship to Germany. And now it's about 25 years ago. So how does it feel like standing here at the property of one of your sons, of your students? How does it feel like?
Dr. Ngasa, you are my son. You are a very active man. I'm so pleased. I'm happy. I'm the happiest man in the world. Because when you talk of that experience that I had with young people in 1987, and that group has kept,
I can see.
Yeah,
the spirit is still
the
on.
The spirit is still on.
Yes.
And I'm so happy because as soon as, for example, you and the other people of that group heard that I was in Germany, you reacted. I'm happy, and I can see that that special group of 1987 was really blessed, because most of you people are all over the world, very active. And I'm really pleased.
Very successful.
Happy. Very successful.
Yes, we have a lot of very, very successful guys back at home too. Some have gone back to Cameroon and have taken up positions of responsibility.
Yes.
Now, let's come back to your work as a writer.
Yes.
Can you please tell us now what it was all about, the latest play which was staged at Mannheim? What was it all about? If somebody in Germany, for example, would want to watch it, did they say they would continue? How long do you know when your play will be on stage? And just put it easily, what is it all about?
Yes, unfortunately, they produced it last year. I wrote the stage already my first play called The König wider Willen, The King.
Against one's will.
Yes, against one's will.
Yes.
And that was about traditional. You know, I wanted to portray the life in our kingdoms and our chieftaincies in back home, and that was interesting. This year, it was an adaptation for the stage of my novel, The Prophecy of the Ancestors. Die Wahrsagung der Ahnen, that they adapted for the stage, and that tells about the not only history and the history of Cameroon, but also of the experience of a young man who comes to Germany and to study, and all the good things and the bad things, the difficulties and the facilities.
So you're talking about us, people like us.
Yes. and even you know, the mixed marriages and so on.
So people like us.
Yes.
So you're going to people like us.
People like you.
Yes.
Not only that, of course, it doesn't go so smoothly always, but
no.
It is so enriching, enriching. What should I say? It's so profitable. When you know this coming together of two cultures, of different cultures, it's always very interesting.
Good.
Yeah.
Now, as I understand, you have another book which you intend to publish.
Yes.
Yes. Do you already have a title for it?
Yeah, the title for it is Mord am Rhein.
So,
Murder
On the Rhine. Yes, the River Rhine in Germany.
Yeah.
So, and it is also, as usual, you write in German.
Yes.
And now the book is primarily targeting the German market. But there are openings for a translation later in English and in other languages.
That's right.
Okay. So I know we wouldn't want to tell us the details about your book.
Yeah.
You want to make it interesting.
Yeah.
But at least you can give us just a small hint. What is at chapter 12?
Chapter 12. Oh, you are a magician. Chapter 12. No. Okay. Seriously, the book is bringing the reader through the life of Africans, Cameroonians, not only Cameroonians, Africans.
Yes.
Not only in Europe but also in Africa, because you know, just in one or two words.
Yes.
A Cameroon lady died in Germany. Am Rhein.
Yes.
And they said it was malaria because she was 2 weeks ago
in Cameroon.
From Cameroon. Okay. But a Cameroonian who is studying in Germany said no.
It doesn't
that's
look,
not true.
It's not normal.
And he left his studies aside and became a detective.
Okay.
And
okay.
In the end, he discovered who the murderers
yes.
were.
Okay. It's really sounds very interesting.
Yes.
So I hope that we will get it. I hope that we will get it a copy very soon.
Yes.
I hope that. How soon do you think that the book could be available?
I'm still struggling to pay my own share, my own contribution of the writer. They have this system that the publishing houses don't spend a loan.
Okay.
They don't invest a loan. So mm-hmm. I'm trying to finish paying my...
Your own share.
Maybe I'm planning before the London book fair,
mm-hmm.
if by April
2013
I have paid, they will bring, because they already worked out the book.
Okay.
Studied. So I'm struggling to have it by the London
book fair, 2013.
Because they have already invited me for that.
April 2013.
Yes, 13.
Okay. Mr. Mepin, it's very interesting talking to you. We could be talking all day, but we still have another mission to look into. We have to travel to Berlin immediately for this very important occasion tomorrow.
Yes.
Yeah, so it's a pleasure talking to you, and maybe we might have another occasion to talk again. So this is Manunga Studio, Dr. Ngasa personally on his premises in Noise Season. That's how we call this our place, Noise Season. So as you can see, our national flag is behind, flag waving.
Very interesting.
Yeah, of course, this is Cameroon in Germany.
I'm lucky to be there.
Yeah, it's Cameroon in Germany. It is our pride to be Cameroonians, and we show it. We don't only say we're Cameroonians.
I'm very grateful.
You see, we have something to show. We have something to prove in Germany.
Very good.
So that's why we feel very welcome. You're welcome here.
Very interesting. Thank you very much.
Okay, bye-bye.